You clicked on this video because you want to become better at PvP in Sea of Thieves. I guess it's your lucky day because that's exactly what I'm going to be helping you with. Before we dive in, it's important to state the main focus of this video will be on duo sloop PvP. However, there will be tips that work across all ships. I will be including timestamps so you can skip to the parts that you are interested in. First things first, you want to prepare your ship for combat. Before setting sail, it's important your ship is stocked up with supplies like cannonballs, chain shots, food and a helm crate. You can get these crates at merchants. And if you have the luxury of having your own captain ship already, you can buy extra supplies at the shipwright shop. These items will appear in the barrels on your ship. A typical PvP supply setup looks something like this. You will want to put cannonballs, chain shots and food in the storage crate. This is the cannoneer's crate. And you want to place it either next to or behind the cannon, so you won't have to walk to refill your pockets. At the start, you will only have one storage crate, so you place the wood crate behind the helm. You can later replace this with another storage crate and put some food for the helm in it too. You get bonus points if you build a wall with empty crates around your cannon. This will prevent you from getting harpooned by the opponents. Since season 11, there is the possibility to dive to a sea fort. You could use this to get some extra supplies at the start, but it's not required. After supplying your ship, it's time to dive for combat. As soon as you reach the surface, it's the helm's job to turn the wheel fully to the right. Meanwhile, the cannoneer should be raising the sail to about halfway. The reason you don't want to have your sail completely down is because you can get an angle faster with the sail raised, plus it will make it easier to aim your cannons. Unless your opponents are going for a parallel fight, the helm should now start turning the wheel back to the left, so you essentially start to orbit around each other. There is a very good reason for wanting to face the left side of your ship to the enemies instead of the right side. First of all, the left side of your ship can take one less hull compared to the right side. The second reason for taking the left side shots is that if the mast gets hit, it will always get damaged on the right side first, and it's much safer to repair on the right side if the shots are coming from the left. There's also a very important third reason that gets often overlooked, which is that the stairs in your boat, from which you will be bucketing, are located on the right side, so you have less chance of taking damage when bucketing if you're taking shots from the left. When you are in battle, as the cannoneer you want to be hitting the opponent's cannoneer first. This helps because the opponents won't be able to return fire and it gives you a huge advantage. We call this having priority. Nearly got one ball there. Oh, I killed him. Meanwhile, it's the helm's job to ensure you maintain your angle and keep the rotation stable without very sudden movements. If the pressure on your own ship is low, the helm should attempt to snipe to increase the pressure on the opponents even further. It's important to keep in mind that sniping is a nice to have, but it shouldn't be the main priority. If there's a lot of pressure on your own ship, the helm should be repairing and bucketing whilst maintaining angle, of course. If the mast or wheel gets damaged, you should prioritize repairing these, but not at the cost of sinking, of course. If the helm is occupied with repairing, it's important the cannoneer keeps him informed about the angle early, so you won't lose it. Angle good?
Yeah, it's fine right now.
That doesn't sound like too optimistic.
Yeah, you're overturning a bit, like some seconds. But
as a cannoneer, it can sometimes be difficult to spot where your shots are landing exactly. As a helm, you can help your cannoneer by telling him if the shots are landing too high, too low, too far left or too far right. This can help increase accuracy massively.
A bit higher.
Alright, thank you.
Very good. Ooh, thanks.
When the opponents have enough pressure and the cannoneer feels like there is a good chance of hitting chain shots on the mast, it's time to go for something what we call a D-mast.
Nice.
Going for chains. I got their mast, I think.
Nice chain.
Yeah, they're D-masted.
There.
It takes two chain shots, one cannonball and one chain shot, or three cannonballs to take a mast down on a sloop. Be aware, a chain shot has more mast than a regular cannonball. This means you will have to aim it higher and further to the left than you usually would. It takes practice to learn exactly where you have to aim. These guys are demasted. If you've taken the mast down, you can immobilize your enemies even further by focusing your cannons towards their helm. The maximum amount the helm can be damaged is tier 3. After that, there's no point in hitting it anymore. Damaging their helm will make it much harder for them to keep an angle on you. It's the helm's job to circle the opponent's ship. This is what we call a death spiral. When death spiraling, it's all about making the opponent's lives as hard as possible, whilst making your own life as easy as possible. If the spiral is stable, the helm can start doing repairs and bucketing the remaining water out. It's all about shifting the balance of pressure so that you will have minimal pressure and your opponents will have maximum pressure. When death spiraling, as a cannoneer, you want to prevent your enemies from getting on the cannons by hitting it if they try to get on it. Other than that, you really want to spread your shots across the entire boat so they will get as many holes as possible.
No way.
If you manage to kill an opponent and the pressure on your own boat is relatively low, it's time to send a boarder over. This will help increase the pressure on your enemies. As a boarder, in most instances, you should drop the anchor on the opponent's ship, as this will prevent them from doing any maneuvers. After that, you should focus on staying alive, because sometimes your presence alone can be enough of a distraction for the one remaining enemy. If you feel like you have a good shot of killing your opponent, you should go for that. But don't put yourself in a bad position that will get you killed. This is what we call playing your life.
I killed one, no way. I'm gonna get deckshot you again.
Yeah, actually deckshot me this time. I have trust. Okay, it's gonna be close. Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, let's go.
Kill him. They're both dead. As a boarder, you get bonus points if you take a bucket of water from your own boat and splash it onto the enemy. This could make all the difference. Be aware, a bucket from the sea does basically nothing though. If you've done everything right, you should be rewarded with the beautiful streak increase message, and you can wave your opponents goodbye as their boat descends to the bottom of the seas. It's important to state that getting really good at PvP in this game will take a lot of practice. I'm dead. Oh my god, bro, they're so lucky. But I hope these tips will help you get really good just that little bit faster. If there's any questions, I would highly suggest you to join my Discord, where we have a beautiful community from beginners to very experienced PvP players. You can also watch me play live on Twitch, where I can answer your questions too. If you want to see more PvP gameplay and tips, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Good luck in your next fight and keep practicing.